The commission was quite specific. The asset was to be terminated.
From the world-famous Blackbird Studios, it's the Rave X Podcast. And now, Rave X.
Oh, hey, what's up there? How you doing? Thanks for tuning into the show. I'm your host, Din Djarin.
This is the way.
This is the way.
And today on the Rave X Podcast, I'm going to tell you a story. A story of a little boy who loved his bike. And that little boy was your hero, Rock Hard Rave X. So we're going to go back in time to simpler days, man, when all you had to care about was your bike if you were a young kid, biking around Fenway Park and shit. And you know what? I'm going to tell you how these motherfuckers stole my bike. All that and more in an action-packed episode of the Rave X Podcast. And with that being said, kids, let's dive in. So, if you guys don't know where I'm from, man, I'm from the Boston area. And I grew up in a lot of different places around Boston, one of which was right near Fenway Park, the iconic Fenway Park, man. And, you know, I never had money to go to no Red Sox game. I don't think I went to my first Red Sox game until I was like 11 or 12 years old. But I used to bike around the area all the time, man. And there was a sort of a wooded area around there called the Fens, right? You know, for Fenway. So I would get on my Huffy bike. I was about 8, 9 years old. And I would bike around through the little wooded area and the trails right by the river. I'm guessing that was Charles River. And, you know, sometimes you'd make friends with people and sometimes you wouldn't. It would be a solo adventure. On this particular day, I'm biking around. I see these two kids, man. They looked familiar to me, but I didn't really recognize them. I saw them kind of around the area, but, you know, you don't remember everyone's faces when you're 9 years old on your bike. So I'm riding around enjoying myself. These two kids, I guess from the projects down the road there, they come up to me, man. They start, hey, man, that's a real nice bike. I'm like, yeah, it's a cool bike. Now, these kids had some booty-ass bikes. One of them was like a beat-up old 10-speed, and the other one was like a pink something girl's bike. I'm pretty sure it was stolen. So they take a great interest in my bike, right? And I'm just like, okay, I'm not going to get off. And they're like, hey, man, can I take a ride on your bike? And these kids were older than me. They were about, I'd say, 12 years old, right? Keep in mind, I'm 9 years old. And I said, no, you know, I really don't let anyone ride my bike. You know, I said, oh, no, you can trust. I said, no, it's not about trust, man. I don't let anyone ride my bike. So they're like, all right, well, you want to go biking together around the Fens? I'm like, yeah, let's go biking. So we're biking, man, you know, and they're trying to keep up with me. And I'm showing off a little bit, man. I'm burning rubber, you know, hitting that back brake, man, burning out, kicking up dust and shit, you know, and then outrunning them by a long, long, long mile, man, just outrunning them and then waiting like, what took you all so long? You see, when your boy Rave X was 9 years old, you're not going to believe this. I was a bit of a show-off. Probably because I'd seen Smokey and the Bandit one too many times. And in my head, I wasn't just some kid on a Huffy bike. I was like Knight Rider or something, or Street Hawk, you know, going on all these adventures. So I kind of thought I earned their respect. And I thought they kind of thought I was cool, man. I was the dude on the bike. And we would jump stuff, man. We found a little ramp. We set up the ramp. And we went and we jumped over. And we're doing all this cool stuff. And we're hanging out with these two kids. And probably about an hour goes by and they go, hey, man, do you want a puppy? And it just came out of left field. And I'm like, do I want a puppy? Yeah, who doesn't want a puppy? He goes, okay, man, we know where there's a couple of puppies at. Just follow us. I'm like, all right, let's go. Sure. So I'm following them. We're biking. They keep commenting on, hey, those are some nice tires on your bike, man. I really like it. And I'm like, yeah, you know, I'm never getting off my bike, so forget about it. No, okay, I'm just saying, there's some nice tires. And I'm like, yeah, no problem, man. So we get all the way away from where we were, from the Fens, right? All the way away from Fenway Park. And there was this sort of a apartment building there. And the building was kind of set up weird where it had a back alleyway where, like, I guess they put, like, the trash cans there and stuff. And there was a very narrow alleyway that went down to this big open courtyard where people would bring out their trash and shit. So we go up to the door and the guy says, well, guy, he was a kid. He says, hey, there's a dog in there that's got some puppies. You can just go take one if you want. We already took one. And I went, huh, there's a dog in there that's got puppies? And they were both like, oh, yeah. And one of the kid gets off his bike and he goes, I'll go and see if the dog's still there. And he gets off his bike and he unlatches the gate, had a little latch bar gate thing. And he goes and he walks down a few feet and he looks and he goes, yeah, the dog's still there. And she's got like 4 more puppies. You can just go take one, man. It's okay. And I went, huh, I wouldn't mind having a puppy. That'd be pretty cool. Okay. And I was distracted, people. They distracted me. That was their plan. I get off my bike, I put it off to the side, I go through this gate, walk all the way down this hall, and it was about maybe 15, 20 foot walk down this very narrow hallway. I look in and I do see a dog on a blanket. A little sad looking, malnourished Doberman Pinscher looking thing. And I said, "Hey doggy, how you doing?" And then I look around and I realize, I don't see no mother effing puppies. I turn around, the gate slams shut, and they took off on my most prized possession, my Huffy bike. And I couldn't believe it. I got duped, hornswoggled, bamboozled. Them mother effers took my mother effing bike. So I run out, I grab the gate, the gate's locked, I shake it, I'm panicking, I can see them taking off. And then I realized I could reach my little skinny 9-year-old arms through the bar and kind of went around and unlatched it. I guess maybe they didn't think I could was able to do that, you know. I open the gate, I run out, I look both ways. At this point, they're gone, because the one kid was on a 10-speed, and the other kid had my lightning-fast Huffy. I don't even know what to do right now. I'm beside myself with anger. I'm not going to lie. Your boy Rave X started crying. I was young. This wasn't like yesterday, kids. You know that. And I just start walking around. I'm looking for my bike. I don't know. I see this dude who I used to see biking around the Fenway area. And I tell him what happened. He's like, "Oh, man, that's messed up. Here, jump on my handlebars. I'll take you around, see if we can find these people." So I jump on the handlebars, man. And with me on the handlebars of this dude's bike, he had a 10-speed. We're not going that fast. And we're kind of looking around. He's like, "All right, well, let's go up here. Let's go over there." Finally, I'm like, "Yo, I think they're just gone with my bike." He goes, "Well, do you want to tell the police?" And I'm like, "Look, let me just go home and tell my dad, see what my dad says, right?" Now, I have to walk home quite a bit because I was probably a mile away from my house, you know. No bike. It's getting cold outside. I'm just hurt and dejected. Horrible. Couldn't believe it. I lost it. My prized possession. Did I mention that? I walk in the house. My dad looks at me. He knows something up. Because when I left, I had a bike. Now I came home bikeless. I look up at my dad and I said, "Dad, something happened." He goes, "I know. Where's your bike?" And I went, "Oh, shit. This mother F is mad at me." He said, "No, I'm not mad at you. I just tell me what happened so we can get it back." Like, he already knew what happened. I tell him a story. There was a puppy. They closed the gate on me. They took off on my bike. Two Puerto Rican kids from the projects. He's like, "Okay, okay." And he looks at me and I can tell he wants to say, "You dumb SOB. You fell for the oldest trick in the book. The old, would you like a puppy trick?" And I'm just hurt. But, you know, he didn't go off on me, man. I was young. He knew it wasn't my fault, you know. So he's like, "All right, let's go downstairs." We go downstairs. We get in his old hatchback car. I don't even know what it was. Beat up old hatchback car. And he said, "Which way did they take off? Did they go left or right?" Because I took him back to the area, you know. And one of the kid's dumb pink bike was still there. He took the kid's bike, threw it in the bushes. We get back in the car. I tell him they went that way. That's all I saw. My dad knew exactly where they went and where they went with my bike. We took off towards the projects in Roxbury, man, away from Boston. We go down there, we pull into the projects, and I had never been into this hood before. This was a bad hood, man. This is the wrong side of the tracks. But Dad knew. We pull in, we start driving through the projects real slow-like. Dad's looking, he says, "You look on that side, I'll look at this side. You tell me if you see your bike." I'm like, "All right." We pull in, we're looking around, and we saw a bunch of kids stripping bikes. But it wasn't my Huffy. Finally, I see these two kids, man, and they're out in front of their house. Man, they had a whole chop shop going on. There was all these bike pieces and parts on the front lawn, and they were out there. They had a boombox going. They had a couple of glasses of Kool-Aid. They felt like they were safe, like they got away with it, you know what I mean? My dad, before I even knew what was going on, throws the car in park, hops out. They look at him like, "What the F? What's going on?" He walks up, grabs my bike. One dude, like, reached for a pair of vice grips. I don't know if he's going to try to swing at my dad or whatever. My dad kicks the vice grips sort of out of his hand so he can't grab it. And then he grabs the other dude's good bike that there was, you know, it was just there, like some other bike that they had probably stolen. My dad grabbed my bike and one of their other prized possession bikes, throws it back in the trunk of the car, looks at them, and he says something in effect of like, "Ever catch you motherfuckers near my son again, it's over, you hear me? It's effing over." And they just ran in the house and closed the door like, fuck that shit, right? We hop in the car. My dad takes off. We go out of the projects. He doesn't say a word. And I'm just looking at him like, why did you take the other bike? He goes, because they deserve it. That's why. An eye for an eye, man. Because they deserve it. I just didn't take your bike. I took their other bike, man. And maybe, you know, come to think of it, maybe that was a lesson for me, which is why I kind of am the way I am now. Which some would say is a mean person. I don't think I'm mean at all. I just think in life, sometimes you gotta be the dove and sometimes you gotta be the hawk, you know? Just to teach people a lesson, drive the point home. And I'm like, okay, Dad, shoot, you got my bike. We get home. My dad takes the bike, takes the tires, off of that nice bike, puts it on my bike, takes the nice handlebars from that bike, puts it on my bike, and whatever was left of that other bike, he just threw it out in the yard, you know, threw it out in the trash. Made my bike better, faster, man. I was like Street Hawk on that little Huffy bike. And then he said, you probably shouldn't ride this around for a while, man. And if you do, if you ever see those kids, just come straight home and tell me. And I was like, all right, cool, no problem. And that was that. And you know, I did just what he said. I didn't ride the bike for a while. And a couple of weeks later, when I did ride the bike, I always looked left and looked right, make sure I didn't see those kids. Didn't go back to that part of the fens anymore. And I never actually saw those kids again, man. And I'm guessing they're probably dead or in jail. And you know, sometimes I thought about it years later. Was there ever really puppies in there at any point? Well, I guess it doesn't matter. Anyway, them motherfuckers stole my bike, and your boy, Rave X, and his dad, Daddy Rave X, got the bike back and took something for our troubles. Damn. What a story, kids. What a story. Well, that's going to wrap it up for me. I got stuff to do. Anyway, hit like, subscribe, follow me on the social, kids. Facebook, facebook.com/RaveXMusic. Bandcamp, ravexmusic.bandcamp.com. For all this and more, tech reviews, podcasts, and new music, always free. And if you hear a podcast that you like, do me a favor, man. Share it with a friend. So until next time, my name's Rave X. Enjoy yourself.
That was the Rave X Podcast. Be sure to click like and subscribe. For podcasts, new music, and all things Rave X, go to youtube.com and search Rave X Music.